Okay. Super Mario. I wonder if I can do it with this controller, because I've swapped to a controller that you cannot see, an invisible controller. See, I'm holding it in front of my face, and I'm going invisible. yeah, I wonder, can I actually play it with this? I totally can. Makes the pointer a little weirder. Yeah, let's do some Mario Galaxy. But I do like the. I do enjoy the Pro Controller better. But then again, for certain sections, it might be difficult. We'll see! Alright, no Trickster Stars. Basically, like an eye tracker. Where are my hands working? Can get it. Okay, was there? Anything in here? No. We are going to the next area. Kind of at a loss for what's coming next. I don't remember much past where we've been. Honey Climb Galaxy, huh? Let's go. Scaling the sticky wall. We'll see how this one goes, and if it goes well, then I'll keep using this controller. But if not, I can always swap back to the Wii notes, but the I was gonna call them nunchucks. They're not nunchucks either. The Joy-Con. Yeah, the only thing that's kind of weird is just. Collecting the star bits. But I figure the reason why it seems like unnatural is probably just because when you first played this game, you were using split controllers back then, too. I guess that makes sense, right? Thank you. Oh, that's gonna be one thing. I'm gonna have to get used to pushing Y for the, for the spin maneuver. For comfort, if you ask me. Ups. I got extremely lucky. I was trying to land on him, see if I could get a coin. The answer is no. But thankfully it's starting me on the final spot, so. Just go straight for it. Dust and sadness. Okay, let's keep going. I'm okay with this controller. For the most part. We got here Gusty Garden Galaxy. Bunnies in the wind. It's like a deconstructed castle grounds. Yes. With Floaty Fluff, you can shake or press Y to fly higher, but only up to 3 times. Still pretty generous, though, at least. Weird little lima bean shaped planetoids. I am not looking for anything on this, am I? Alright. More. Okay, is now when the bunnies come into play? You can catch me. Boing. Okay, you got me. Here, take this. Boing. Yeah, it seriously is like a castle garden just deconstructed. I was saying that I like this, but This just works better. It makes more sense. The dirty tricks of Major Burrows. Oh, okay. I remember this. I'm actually kind of impressed that I managed to make it. There's another. Really does look like the little, like the hungry little caterpillar or whatever. Infested. didn't mean to. They seem to have caught his attention. He's so big and fluffy! You can't get me, Blue Shell. I am the danger. I am the one who knocks. I am the one who homes in on your location. I'm sure by the time that we finish this one, there'll be like maybe another Trickster comment. Gusty Guardian's Gravity Scramble! Did I say Gusty Guardian? I meant Gusty Garden. Dangerous maneuver. Probably not do that. Yeah. Do about it. Okay, so I killed all the rollies. Oh, I think I have an idea. It has nothing to do with anything here. It has everything to do with, getting all those coins. It has to, right? Well, I got some extra star bits, so I guess that's not that bad. Oh, that worked out perfect. I couldn't have asked for a better, like, jump. Danger, watch where he's at. Certainly don't like that. But I like the idea of having this. Yeah. Come on. I'm actually kind of impressed that I got that first right. There's been a couple of things here where I'm just like, I got it first try and I'm kind of happy with it. Is a secret star, so why don't we go ahead and go after that? It shouldn't be that hard, I can't imagine. Which one is it part of? The gravity scramble? I just want to die. What am I missing here? The issue is that I don't have enough height. Is it the coins or is it something else? I did surely miss something here. I have the feeling that that's it. You know what I mean? Kills it. I don't think I can do it. If it is like a star or something, how am I gonna last that long to get here? Just kill me, kill me, kill me, kill me, kill me. Banner in the back of my head.
You can dodge a ball, you can dodge a wrench.
Or is it the other way around? Oh, come on. Sometimes it's like I can't even kill myself even if I'm trying.
Thank you.
This is almost kind of scarier than being like spaghettified in a black hole, just falling into complete unknown. Collected with my butt. Knew it was the golden chomp. Okay, let's keep going. A little bit more time, like 15 more minutes. 26, huh? Oh shit, there is the Daredevil comment. Is it Daredevil for the boss? This one might be tricky. I mean, it has to be Daredevil for the boss, right? Yeah. But it's gonna put me like right there in front of him, so I'm not really too worried about it. This is tricky though. Holy shit! God damn it. I was actually pretty impressed with that. Don't go towards him, he moves too fast. Just stand still and wait.
Yeah.
Why didn't I pound? Why didn't I pound? Pounding was the only thing that I had to do. I was standing still and waiting. Somebody, anybody help! Same way as the first time I got that far. At least I can semi-reliably gain lives. This is a time trial. I'd say that that's a pretty good time. One secret star coming up.
You're gonna love my nuts.
Excuse me. Chapter. Are there any trickster comments anywhere? No. Okay. I don't want to start a new world. I want to move on to something else. So we're actually going to go listen to the next chapter of the story. Where's Luigi? Chapter 6, Friends. Then one day, while the girl sat sipping tea, a tiny apricot-colored planet appeared on the horizon. From the planet, another Luma of the same color emerged. "Do you two know each other?" the girl asked the two Lumas gleefully. Despite the girl's excitement, they seemed uneasy. The two Lumas neither drew closer nor backed away from each other. Instead, they just stared. Then one Luma broke the silence.
My mama!
At once, the apricot Luma parroted back,
My mama! My mama!
My mama, my mama!
The two Lumas began to dance around the girl frantically, and neither showed any sign of stopping. The girl was so charmed by this adorable scene that she couldn't help but laugh. And that's when something very strange happened. Suddenly, more Lumas began to pop out from the apricot planet. They were different colors, but they all shouted the same thing. My mama! My mama! The sight of all the shouting Lumas only made the girl laugh harder. What am I going to do with all these children? The Lumas just stared blankly as she doubled over laughing. Guess we'll have to name each and every one of you. Tomorrow, when she had finished naming them all, she would begin moving all the Lumas into the new house. And that should do it for today. At least for Mario. I'll be back soon with something else. Bye for now.